What's up, guys? Raymond here. And well, who'd have thought Robinhood has just removed those pesky trade restrictions that just last week they put in place in order to combat this whole madness that we've recently seen in the stock market. As you probably already know, Robinhood has been getting a lot of flack, a lot of heat in the last week or two because of those decisions that they made to completely ban their customers from opening any new trades on stocks like GameStop, AMC, Nokia, and so on and so forth. So let's take GameStop, for example. The day opened around $57, $58 or so. Let's even say 60 bucks. It went up all the way in the high 80s, I believe. But then now it's back down to around $60 per share. So it's a good thing that Robinhood has taken off these restrictions. It's going to allow their customers, it's going to allow some of their investors to really go in on those stocks like GameStop and AMC and all those other stocks that they banned. And now we can start to see some normal trading volume in the market again. So that should probably be a good thing overall for those stocks that are involved. So we'll have to take a wait and see approach. But always remember, make sure that you're doing your fundamental analysis. Make sure you have a good understanding of why you're investing into a stock. Don't just buy into something blindly just because you heard a good stock tip somewhere. Now, there is some chatter that is starting to go around in the market saying that since all of these restrictions have just now been lifted, that this could be the catalyst that we need to do another 2.0 or a short squeeze 2.0 on GameStop and all these other stocks as well. Not really sure how likely that is to happen. Who knows? We could see a part two. Not sure. Or we could just see these stocks continue to plummet like they have been. I know GameStop from the highs last week is down around 80%. From that price as we speak right now. So again, we'll wait and see. We might be in a build-up phase, accumulation phase, and we might see a move higher. It's either way, it's gonna be fun to watch. I know it is gonna be for me. And then also keep in mind, as far as Robinhood goes, next week on the 18th, they're gonna have a hearing in front of the House committee. So let's make sure when we're investing, we're doing our fundamental analysis, make sure that it's a sound investment. And yeah, I think we'll be perfectly fine for anything that comes our way. So just wanted to give you a brief update on Robinhood. Again, those restrictions have been lifted. Thank goodness. Now we can get back to some sense of normality, some sense of, you know, being able to do what we want without all the hamstringing and all the limitations that have been put in place recently. Hey, before you go though, don't forget to smash that like button. It really helps me out with the algorithm. Also, consider subbing to the channel. I make videos just like this one every single week, multiple times a week on personal finance, investing. And again, my name is Raymond. If you enjoyed this video, I hope to see you in the next video. Peace.